XFM News. On point.
Thank you for joining us. Here's a quick look at the news. I'm Lynn Komjisha. Retired General Henry Tumukunde has praised the Health Minister Jane Ruth Acheng and promised to retain her in his government in case he wins the 2021 general elections. Tumukunde says Dr. Acheng is one of the few ministers in the NRM government who've dedicatedly served the country, citing the good leadership she's offered to the health sector and the government in general in the COVID-19 pandemic. Tumukunde made the pledge at a press conference he held this morning as he wound up his campaign in the Langa sub-region with the Tuke and Alebutong.
If I became a president, me, I would appoint Lucy Acheng, Minister of Health. In February, if you hear me, and it's likely a possibility, especially from the pressure I have, I would still appoint her out of personal professional merit. But you see, the other question is, what do they carry along for our people here? That's a fundamental question I want to ask. I traveled all your roads. I've not seen as bad roads as I have seen in this area. I have looked at your schools, because for me, I'm not 25 like some of you. Apart from a few private schools, what is there to add on?
Bank of Uganda has revealed commercial banks have restructured loans worth 6.7 trillion shillings in the first quarter of this financial year since the onset of COVID-19. When the country was under lockdown, Bank of Uganda encouraged commercial banks to restructure loans with its customers whose loan repayment was affected by the pandemic. In its quarterly financial stability review report released by the central bank, it has been revealed the cumulative loans that were granted credit relief between April 2020 and end September 2020 amount to 6.7 trillion shillings. The report further revealed the acceptance rate for applications is high at 97.4%. The report also reveals banks have been forced to restructure some loans for a second time, and this increased from 264.1 billion shillings in August to 424.9 billion shillings in September. Council Male Mabalizi has filed petition in the East African Court of Justice seeking an order compelling government to compensate the people who lost their lives during the riots of last month. Following the arrest of presidential candidate Robert Kyagulanyi Ssentamu on 18th November, some people staged various demonstrations across the country, resulting into the death of some 54 people by armed security operatives. Mabalizi contends that the government failed to contain the riotous situation and resorted to killing people, including the innocent, yet the security had the capacity to arrest the suspects and have them charged in courts of law.
Under the South African Treaty, specifically Articles 6D and 7.2, Uganda is supposed to comply with the rule of law. So when the law says people must, if they riot, they must go for 3 years in prison, that should be the law. And again, even those 3 years must come after fair hearing. But now, bring a system where you kill people by shooting them. Who shoots them? People in plain clothes. Of course, we know that UPDF and others must be in uniform so that someone can be able to know that now I'm.
Police in Kabarore District has arrested 7 suspects for allegedly participating in the murder of a suspected cattle robber. The incident happened at Mumbangane in Kijura this morning when a group of people attacked the suspects and started beating them after putting them on a pickup, which took them to Fort Porto Central Police Station. But Asimwe had passed on. Vincent Twesije, the Rwenzori West Regional Police spokesperson, confirmed the mob and identified the dead as James Asimwe, 29, a resident of Chidede Village in Busoro Sub-County. Twesije said they are the 4 suspected robbers who were beaten are currently being treated at Fort Porto Regional Referral Hospital. Twesije said Asimwe's body was taken to Fort Porto Regional Referral Hospital for post-mortem, and the 4 victims also admitted at the same hospital. He warned the public against taking the law into their hands, saying mob justice is criminal and the perpetrators will be prosecuted once arrested. In other news this afternoon, South Sudan's main opposition party has set a mandatory 40% quota for women, according to its leader, Riek Machar. The Sudan People's Liberation Movement in opposition said the move was informed by the contribution women made in the struggle for independence from Sudan. The party joined the country's unity government in February last year in a peace deal aimed at ending 6 years of civil war. The unity government is in power for a transitional three-year period that will end in fresh elections. I quote, women were with male soldiers in the front line, so let's raise the bar to 40% officially. Let's put it in our resolutions that the affirmative action is going to be 40%, Machar said. The party had held its first national conference in the capital, Juba. The five-day meeting was attended by 1,399 delegates from the 10 regional states and the three administrative areas. The delegates also endorsed the appointment of Regina Joseph Kappa as Interim Security General of ISPLM in opposition. Her appointment comes after Tingo Peter resigned last month. That was the news.
XFM News.